behalf of Director David Evans and the men and women of the Massachusetts Firefighting Academy, I'd like to welcome everyone to the commencement exercises for the 268th graduate class of the Massachusetts Firefighting Academy's Career Recruit Firefighter Training Program. At this time, I ask that you please welcome our presiding officer for today's ceremony, Director David Evans, accompanied by the official party. led in by members of the Greater Boston Pipes and Drums. Please remain standing for our national anthem.
We are grateful for the class of number 268, for their willingness to accept and answer your call upon their lives to serve their communities through the fire service. We are grateful for their families and friends who have encouraged, supported, and prayed for them along this journey. We are grateful for the Fire Academy and the teaching it provides to help make them the best that they can be. Make yourself present among our ceremonies this day. May they be an inspiration to all who participate and witness them. May they inspire us as we leave this place to be more and more the people you have called us to be, serving you by serving our communities. All this we ask in your great and holy name. Amen.
Please be seated. Again, welcome everyone. My name is Joseph Klosek and I currently serve as the Deputy Director of the Massachusetts Firefighting Academy. I'd like to take a moment to let you know who makes up today's official party. I will temporarily bypass the two gentlemen to my immediate left and I will start with the individual near center. He's the presiding officer for today's ceremony. The individual who's in charge of overseeing all operations of the Massachusetts Firefighting Academy here in Stow, our Springfield campus, and the remote satellite facilities across the Commonwealth. Director David Evans. Next to the director is a member of the Massachusetts Fire Training Council, the group that puts forth and oversees all policies regarding training for the Massachusetts Firefighting Academy. From the Newton Fire Department, Chief Bruce Croyer. Just met the next gentleman. He is a member of the Massachusetts Corps of Fire Chaplains and the chaplain of the Danvers Fire Department, Reverend Matthew Purcell. keynote speaker for today's ceremony is retired chief of the Lawrence Fire Department, Chief Larry Marquis. I'll tell you a little more about the chief in a few moments. It is the role, the task of the Career Recruit Firefighter Training Program to take a group of young, impressionable firefighters new to the fire service, introduce them to the history of the fire service, teach and educate them to handle the challenges of today, and certainly the challenges that they're guaranteed to face tomorrow. Not only does this program meet the national standard, it exceeds it. The Massachusetts Firefighting Academy is so lucky to have at the head of it program coordinator, Mr. Dennis Ball. And he is assisted by the man who oversees the quality of this program for quite a few years now, making it the nationally recognized recruit firefighter training program in this country. Assistant Program Coordinator, Mr. Jack Gelinas. This academy is blessed to be affiliated with a group of trained and dedicated professionals, the men and women that make up the instructor corps and the support staff that day in and day out, under any condition that Mother Nature throws our way, will ensure that the firefighters of the Commonwealth are the best trained in the nation. Most of those individuals cannot be with us today because they're doing what you may have seen just a little while ago, they're out training firefighters. Although we do have a few scattered along the outside of the wall, I'd like to take just a moment to say thank you for what you do for us each and every single day. And lastly, there's a lovely young lady who works tirelessly behind the scenes up on the second floor of the academy, handling everything administratively for all of our recruit programs. You may have met her, she may have been handing out the flyers when we first arrived today's ceremony. She is in the back, Ms. Christine Dancer. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the pleasure of introducing the director of the Massachusetts Firefighting Academy, Mr. David Evans.
Did give me his speech to read to you today, so I should be up here 5 minutes. So anyway, I want to mirror the thoughts of that deputy as well. The gentlemen and the ladies around in the white or in the blue, our instructors, I say this every time I get a chance to, I'm biased, I feel we have the best instructors in the world, and it shows every time we do one of these classes of graduation. So please, would you say one more time thank you to my instructors, my Criven facility people. I'd like to welcome all of you here today, because without you, these gentlemen here in front of you would not be here, okay? I want to thank the chiefs to my right, and all the gentlemen and ladies in blue, or the ones sitting down, the firefighters that are here as well. Again, without you, you wouldn't necessarily see the people in front of you right now that are going to be walking across this stage in a little bit to graduate. Okay, so trust me, when I say thank you to those sleepless nights, the missing dinners, the child going to bed, the countless hours studying, I'm always the first one to say thank you to the friends, families, and the fire service members that have helped these gentlemen and women that graduate through the academy. So again, why don't you give yourself an applause as well, the families and friends. We also have a couple people from the State Senate and State House of Reps with us today. I'd like to thank Senator Brady and the Representative Gentile. Thank you for being with us. The House and Senate have always been good to us in public safety. So thank you for being here and helping with us today. Yells out, you made it, okay? So 10 weeks ago you started, okay? And you came in, and he likes to talk a little bit about individuals and teams. I'd like to say it's the ultimate team sport, Okay? You now have joined the ultimate team sport. Whether you played high school sports, or you were in the music, or you were in college and you played, you know, sports or music or whatever, you're in the band or the drama, you know how much time and effort you put into something like that. Okay, but here it's a little different. Okay, because what you do, what you learn, it's gonna you're taught to save your life, your partner's life, and the lives of your community members out there. So that's why I always like to say it's the ultimate team sport. I agree with the marshal. When you came in here, you know, 10 weeks ago, you came in by yourself, or maybe with one or two from your department. But when you leave here, you're gonna have another 20 or 30 or so men and women that you will call brothers, sisters in arms. You know that on a mutual aid call, or maybe on a call that you have in your own town, they're gonna be there with you, okay? They're gonna be with you 24/7, just like your family, your wife, your better half, your husband, whatever, they're all gonna be there with you. So take a look around you, you'll probably see them again. Maybe tomorrow, some of you will be taking your first shift tomorrow, maybe. So take care of each other out there. Make sure that you do everything you're supposed to be doing in the mornings, eat, sleep, all that kind of stuff. And I'm sure the people out here will mirror that as well. I'd like to give some points of advice before. You know, I know the marshal likes to get up here and a little song and dance sometimes when it comes to advice. And for me, I was in education my whole life. Spent 30 years in education. I'm in my 14th year as a firefighter. And I've been in front of people many, many times. But it's the advice you take when you leave one of these things, one of these graduations, that will either help you or not when you get out there in the real world. Okay, and I'm sure that the chiefs over here, the gentlemen and ladies in the blue out back, will mirror some of these as well. So, listen. Make sure when you leave here, you listen. Be a good listener. Because you're not going to know everything after 10 weeks. Trust me. All right? When you get on that first real call, and there's going to be many. There's going to be many false alarms. There's going to be many real ones. Listen to what those people out there tell you. It'll help. Because in the bad days and in the good days, you're going to be there and you're going to ask a question. And someone's going to be there to answer it for you. All right? So be a good listener when you get back to your house. Listen to your chiefs, your captains, your lieutenants, the other firefighters. Trust me, they know what they're doing. Okay? Rely on each other. Rely on your fellow firefighters. Search and rescue. You want a primary, a secondary. You know, we've had people come up here and tell stories at these graduations about very first shifts, you know, or a couple of years into their shifts, or whatever. Things really happen. You really do fall back on your training from here. Okay? Pay attention to the little things. Little things will save your life and your partner's life. Okay? Remember to continue to train. Don't think you know it all. Please don't. If you think you know it all, it's time, even though it's your first day, it could be your last day. All right? Continue to learn. Continue to ask questions. Rely on or lean on the people to my right, the people in the back, the people sitting down. Okay? When you get out there and you take that first ride, and you go into that first medical, or it's a first fire. Listen, understand what happens, and then train again. Because when you leave here today, it's not the end of it's the end of your training. You're gonna be, hopefully you do a whole bunch more. And you come back and visit us often, okay? Remember to be safe, all right? And you just had a couple of lectures over the last couple of days, one of them being on cancer, one of them being on crisis intervention. Cancer is real. Okay, and I would be naive to think that all the teaching and all the learning over the last few years goes to waste. Okay, so wear your SCBA, wear your mask. Alright? Don't do what they do on television. Alright? Be safe. Everybody goes home. Congratulations to 6-8. Thank you.
Fire Training Council, present the Richard N. Bangs Outstanding Recruit Award.
Morning, everyone. Richard N. Bangs is the chairman of the Massachusetts Fire Training Council for many years. Upon his retirement, the council voted to name the Outstanding Student Award in his honor. The recruit training curriculum is designed to train and evaluate students in the basic skills of the firefighting profession. This course is demanding both academically and physically. In completing, it is an accomplishment worthy of recognition. In each class, there is one student selected who has excelled in the training program, and this student is named as the Outstanding Student of the class. This award is based upon the student's total academic score, successful achievement in both academic and practical skills, testing, and evaluations. At this time, I'd like to invite Chief Anthony Stowers of the Maynard Fire Department to join us on stage. Very pleased to present the Richard N. Bangs Award to the Outstanding Student of Recruit Class 268, the firefighter Alec Martina of the Maynard.
Sense of humor. Well, at times they would, when they would shift from one skit to the next, you'd hear one of the actors, John Cleese. Many of us are familiar with him in some of the American movies he's made. You'd hear him say, "And now for something entirely different." Well, we're going to employ those words today because we're going to kind of veer off course from the normal graduation program, and we're going to hear from a very, very special individual. This individual is a recent recipient of the Richard N. Bangs Outstanding Recruit Award. Ladies and gentlemen, firefighter Alec Martinek of the Maynard Fire Department. Chief Marquis is a veteran of the United States Army as well as the United States Navy, and has served as an instructor for the Massachusetts Firefighting Academy for over 20 years. His background affords him a unique perspective on training, team building, and family. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Chief Larry Marquis.
Training, you're not going to know everything. As mentioned before, there's a lot to learn. just build a good foundation to build upon and continue this training whenever possible. A few things I want to keep in mind is this. You work for the public. The public doesn't work for you. Treat them with respect. It doesn't matter if the man has a big mansion or a homeless person. Treat them right. That's the way it should be. Also, I've seen this time and time again where people in general tend to act like firefighters, police, and so on. They embarrass themselves, their family, and their department. Keep it straight and narrow. Keep yourself out of trouble. And also, I want him to be a future partner. Now, how many of you want to become officers in the future? Show of hands. Way up, get it up. Good, that's a good thing. Because the ratio is 4-1, you know, of you becoming an officer. 25% of you will be officers. I think when you go to your departments within the next, possibly this week and next week, look around. There's going to be some outstanding officers, people you look up to. Use them as a role model. And then we also have some officers that are, let's say, questionable. You know, make a role model out of what officer can continue this. It's very important. Now, don't complain about it, about your officers. Do something about it. Study hard, take the exams, and do what you can, and live with what happens. Now, there's nothing wrong with being a good firefighter, too. I respect the opinion of experienced firefighters. You know, I'll pick their brains like anybody else. And then you have to make a decision what you're going to do. So that's the way it is. In the city of Lawrence, when I first started taking exams, I was on the job 3 years. I knew I wasn't ready, but I wanted to know the format of the exam. So it had taken us like maybe an hour. But when I had five years on that job, I looked at who was studying and taking the exams. And I could work with you, you, and you. But this gentleman over here scares me. That was the main push. It's not strictly money, it's survival. So I studied, did reasonably well. I came in third. And the city of Lawrence, what they did was they went, when I made the appointments, they waited until it was three appointments. Appointed four. They won 1, 2, 7, and 8 on the list. And that's the upshot. See that there were politics in the city of Lawrence. No, that happened. So doing the right thing. The union said it was wonderful. So I subpoenaed the chief. I had to hire an attorney. This is how you make friends. Subpoenaed the chief, subpoenaed the mayor. Then after 2 years, I did make the lieutenant. The history continues, demoted from the cutbacks. Got thrown off the top of the captain's list. Got back on the captain's list, went to Superior Court. It wasn't easy. Then made deputy chief, and then the chief's job was borderline as far as I knew an attorney. Usually you don't have to do this. But when you make friends, you know, you step on a few toes, you're gonna pay. So I did. And the thing is this, the point behind that story is never give up. Continue, try hard, don't give up. And my first time, my first station was a dual company. It was on South Lawrence, an engine company and a ladder company. I walked in, and it looked like an old folks home. Everybody was 60 years old, 62 or so. They were veterans, World War II, Korea, hardcore, good bunch. Knew what they had to do, and so, after about 3 months, I felt comfortable. This is the way we were trained in the past. Oh, I forgot to mention that I think the academy standards are 10 weeks. It's great, it's good for you. When I first started, I had 5 days of OJT. That was it. We dressed the hydrant. Look, ground ladders, here's an SDA, plant this on your face, crack the valve, and your lieutenant will teach you the rest. They don't do that anymore, which is a good thing. So I go back to the two stations, an engine and a ladder, I was assigned to the engine. After about 3 months, I felt comfortable with the engine, constant review. And I was speaking with the house captain at 8 o'clock in the morning, maybe around the kitchen table, maybe smoking cigarettes and playing cards. This is what we did in the past. So I say, Captain, teach me how to tell. The tilling is when you have a steering wheel in the front and a steering wheel in the back. quarterback patrol the back end of the ladder. He said, sure, as he's thrown off the cards, smoking the cigarettes. Okay, following week in the cap, can you teach me how to tilt? More cigarettes, more cards. He said, yeah, sure, I'll teach you. I figured he didn't want to teach me how to play, you know, how to tilt. So 4 weeks go by, 6 weeks. I walk in at 7:30 in the morning. He says, hey, you're tilling today. This is the way they did things. So about 10 of 8, we go up the engine to take a left on Bailey Street, about 75 feet. Take another left, go south on South Union, about 3/4 mile, do a few donuts. Come north on South Union Street, take a right on Bailey, back it into the station. It's an old station, but it's 100 years old, with 6 inches of clearance on each side of the tiller, the ladder. So it was very tight, he had 6 inches. Back into the station. The whole training process was about 10 minutes. They went back to say you're a natural. They broke up the cigarettes and the cards. This is what they did. So it wasn't fair. It was on pins and needles all day. The thing is, you have to be prepared. Prepare yourself for everything. So now it was on pins and needles. Later on, one of the old veterans said, you want to play cards? I said, I don't know how to play. So he put his arms around me, escorted to the table, he said, we'll teach you. And I paid for my education, but it wasn't that easy. But as far as the OJT, I worked with some very good officers, you know, a lot of hands-on. In the early 90s, 3 or 4 years running, I worked with some of these chiefs in the past, where we were averaging about 125 to 150 arson fires a year. That's a lot of OJT. And then besides the accidental fires, which did happen. So we did that. The thing is, when I started working at the Fire Academy in the mid-90s, granted I was seasoned, but it did pick up, it made life so much easier. Picking up these pointers as far as putting on fires and so on at the academy. Kind of filtered my background. It worked out well. And I have no complaints. I've been here for 20 years. Every day I learned something from the instructors, the staff, and if I don't learn anything about incidents or fires, I learn about people, which is very important also. And I don't think you see all the background activity that happens with the staff and instructors, but they're constantly improving the program. It's very dynamic. They make changes, tweaks constantly. To improve the program, we spend a lot of time doing this. They're a dedicated bunch. They do well. And the third thing is this, the families. I'd like to thank the family for supporting the recruits the last 10 weeks. Continue to support the recruits. Like it was mentioned before, they're gonna have good days and bad days. There's gonna be some funny incidents they'll tell you about. And you think you were making this up. It's the honest to God's truth. And incidents that are sad and tragic. And there's other incidents they won't talk about. So keep in mind, support them. Final thoughts, never give up. God bless and stay safe.
Before we call the roll, I'd like to ask all the veterans in the class and all the veterans in the house, please stand up and be recognized. Thank you. Thank you for your service. Firefighter Leo Rogers. Burlington, Fire Chief Stephen Yetman. Graduating firefighter Connor McLean. Of Canton, Fire Chief Charles Duty. Graduating firefighter Michael White. Assisting in this presentation, Chelsea firefighter Blady Sanchez, who is the cousin of graduating firefighter David Bielman. Danvers, Fire Chief Robert Iger. Graduating firefighter Alexander Berry. Bridgewater, Fire Chief Craig, Deputy Fire Chief Craig Windsor. Graduating firefighter Preston Klein. Of Fairhaven, Fire Chief Timothy Francis.
Good luck.
Graduating firefighter Troy Tegudo. Graduating firefighter Sean Harrington. Of Fitchburg. Fire Chief Kevin Roy. Graduating firefighter Connor Griffin. Of Gardner, Fire Chief Richard Aries. Graduating firefighter Lorenzo Calderon. Of Gloucester, Assistant Fire Chief Joe Aiello. And assisting in this presentation, Gloucester Deputy Fire Chief Andrew McRobb, who is the father of graduating firefighter Lucas McRobb. Hanover, the fire, Deputy Fire Chief Jason Cavallaro. Graduating Firefighter Thomas Duggan. Graduating Firefighter Jonathan Goodwin. Graduating Firefighter Gregory Ryan. Of Hingham, Fire Chief Stephen Murphy. Graduating Firefighter Ryan Dunn. Of Hopkinton, Fire Chief Stephen Slayman. Graduating Firefighter Patrick Rahill. Of Maynard, Fire Chief Anthony Stowers. Graduating Firefighter Jack Bertanassi. Graduating Firefighter Brian Kramer. Graduating Firefighter Alex Martinez. Graduating Firefighter Edwin Wasier. Methuen, Assistant Fire Chief Bill Barry. graduating firefighter Ryan Colvin. Graduating firefighter Luis Agaglioni. Of Newton, Fire Chief Bruce Breuer. Graduating firefighter Kevin Hennigan. And assisting in this presentation, Newton Police Officer John Hennigan, who is Kevin's father. Andover, Fire Chief William McCarthy. Graduating firefighter Nick Matoni. Of Norwell, Fire Chief T. Andrew Reardon. Graduating firefighter Peter Senatori. Randolph, Fire Chief Richard Donovan. Graduating firefighter Colin Gray. Graduating firefighter Dennis Lee. Graduating firefighter Daniel Pasquantonio. Scituate, Fire Chief John Murphy. Assisting in this presentation, Abington Fire Chief John Nuttall, who is the father of graduating firefighter Timothy Nuttall. Seekonk, Fire Captain Michael Brook. And assisting this presentation, Fire Lieutenant William George. graduating firefighter Justin Lamonti. Wayland, Assistant Chief Neil McPherson. Graduating Firefighter Andrew Welch. Wellfleet, Fire Captain Joseph Capello. Graduating Firefighter Gary Doolittle. Bridgewater, Fire Chief Kenneth May. Graduating Firefighter Justin Donna. Westford, Fire Chief Joe Targ. Graduating Firefighter Jonathan Zelensky. Weymouth, Fire Chief Keith Stark. Graduating Firefighter Jason O'Brien. Recruit class 268.
Of the Maynard Fire Department.
really don't know where to start. The Deputy Marshal stole my speech. So I'll just start by saying thank you to everyone that came and welcoming you to the graduation of Class 268. It's been 10 weeks that none of us will forget, for the good and for the bad. But none of this would have been possible without the fire chiefs giving us the opportunity. Thank you to the chiefs for hiring us and starting a new generation of firemen. And thank you to the instructors who motivated us in different ways during the hot mornings and cold mornings of PT to the long days of hazmat. But mainly I'd like to thank the families and loved ones for putting up with us every day when we come home hot and sweaty and tired and in great moods. It can take anybody to be a fireman, but it takes a special few to deal with us. Thank you. The families, you also just signed up for the best job on earth. Even though you don't know it yet, it'll be a learning curve for all of us. The missed holidays, coming home from the long, dirty shifts, you're the ones that need to be there for us. We started off with 38 different men from 28 different departments, to now 38 new friends. We still know how to get on each other's nerves, and we do it more that we're all good friends. The constant joking around, 61, you all right? You look flustered. That's one. 60 in the locker room with water bottles, making messes, and letting 41 know every day, at the end of the day, that we're all here so we can get the instructors to let us go home a couple minutes early. We'll all have these inside jokes till the day we retire and we're still sitting at the pub, sharing these insiders, drinking a cold one. But until then, my friends, the training doesn't stop here. As one of the instructors said on one of our last days, if you look around the firehouse and you don't see that guy could be you. Remember to keep training, keep moving forward. Don't be that guy. Like the Dropkick Murphy said, good luck be with you. You go your way, I'll go mine. So until next time, it's farewell, not goodbye. Good luck, my brothers.
These moments, we ask that you would bless us as we leave this place. We ask a special blessing upon the class number 268. We ask that you would grant them wisdom and courage as they begin this new phase in their life. Help them to be all that you have called them to be, in your service, in your hope, in your love. Be with us now and make us to dwell in safety until we are gathered together again. To you shall be all the praise.
Ladies and gentlemen, this does conclude today's ceremony. On behalf of Director David Evans and the men and women of the Massachusetts Firefighting Academy, I'd like to thank each and every one of you for sharing in this very special day with us. To the members of Class 268, we wish you nothing but long, healthy, and safe careers. I ask you please remain standing for the departure of the official party, followed by the departure of the Chiefs of Department, and then the Greater Boston Pipes and Drums will lead out Class 268.